Good day to everyone. This is Edward at Delray Beach Motors getting ready to do an up close and personal review of this 1961 Chevrolet Impala convertible. The first thing we're going to take a look at is the bumper on this car. You're going to notice that on the ends, there's a little bit of bumper discoloration. Coming around the front, the top of it has a little bit of wear. There's no visible signs of rust, or I should say any serious rust. The bumper is in good enough condition to definitely have it re-chromed if you wanted to. Front headlight bezels. Right turn signal, grill. In very good condition. The bumper stops are still in. Grill emblems were obviously replaced at some point. Really good condition. The hood itself, the paint overall is pretty nice. I don't see any sand scratches. I don't see any signs of any body work being done to it. Body lines, the hood actually lines up with the fender very nice. Nice crisp body line all the way back up into the windshield. Okay, windshield trim, very good condition. The windshield itself, no visible signs of any chips. Trim is very shiny. Okay. Driver's side, fender. Once again, the body line, very crisp, very clean. Bottom of the fender seems to be very solid. Inner fender well. Very clean. Driver's side door, trim in really good condition. Door handles seem to be original. If not, they were replaced a long time ago, showing signs of wear. Door lock in good condition. Once again, body line. Very good. Rocker seems to be pretty solid. This is the only visible damage of the body that I found, is once you open the door, and you look inside the jam, at the corner of the jam, it looks like it had been at some point chipped. It's showing light signs of rust, but not bad. Very easily fixed. Door panel. Driver's door, very good. Dash panel, top of the dash, really solid. Steering wheel could use to be refinished. Inside the glove box is where they hid the double din radio. Very nicely done. Speakers are in the kick panels. And then there's a set of removable speakers in the rear. Door closes very nice. I am noticing on the lower part of the door, there's a little bit of fit issue there, but it's lining up on the fender nicely. Side skirts and the quarter panels in really good condition. Seeing a little bit of potential issue here in the future. Little bubble. I don't know if that's body work that's bubbling or potentially a little bit of rust, but definitely addressable. lower quarter panels. You know, when we get on the lift, we'll take a better look, but for the most part, everything's looking really, really good. Rear trunk lines, very clean and nice. Tail light. Rear bumper's in the same condition as the front. Showing a little bit of sign of wear on the top, but not bad. Very respectable for its age. Passenger quarter panel. No signs of any bodywork popping or any bubble rust. Very clean. Okay, driver's or passenger's door. Really clean. Again, you see a little sign of something dripping here. I don't know if it's coming from the door. We'll check that when it's on the rack. Once again, the door panel, front seat in really good condition. Dash, remove these. Get a better look at the rear seat. Great condition. Let's take a look. Door closes as it should. Right fender, really good condition. No signs of bodywork. Hubcaps look to be all in good condition. Tires, plenty of tread depth. You want to put the rear the top up for me?
Sure.
Go ahead and give it a start too. Starts right up. Top looks to be in really, really good condition. I want you to put it back down in a second. A little dirty, but probably because it's been sitting down for so long. Back glass is in good condition. Well, I should say the back plastic is in good condition. Needs to be bleached, but overall it's in good condition. All right, go ahead and put it down. Alright, come pop the hood, leave it running. She's purring. Firewall's solid. Body tag is in place. I have pictures of it. You can see at some point someone drove a screw in from the other side and damaged a piece of the body tag, but it's intake and it's got the original rivets in place. Obviously, it looks like at some point the wiring harness has changed in this. The wiring harness looks to be new. Motor idles pretty smooth. It's got a Brawler carburetor on it. The only thing that I'm seeing is it looks like the water neck is leaking a little bit of antifreeze by the thermostat on the top of the motor. It coming out of the water. For some reason the video stopped shooting, but you see the water neck leaking a little bit. It's coming out of the thermostat housing between the intake. That's an easy fix for us. It looks like someone at some point had done the control arm bushing, so they've been replaced. You know, all the hoses are in really, really good condition, have been replaced. You know, the motor's just sitting here idling and barely even shaking. Like I said, I don't know if you got this, but the wiring harness has all been fresh on it. Shroud's in really good condition. All the electrical looks to be new. Got the horn. Radiator's in really good condition. Okay. So listen, the next step is let's put this baby on the lift and see how she looks.
Okay,
so we got this big girl on the rack. I gotta say, I took a quick glance at it, and overall, I'm very happy with the condition of it, but there is a few areas that we should address. First, we're gonna look at this trunk pan, which for the most case is pretty solid. But you can see right here, there's some signs of rust, so it should be addressed. Now, either this could be patched, and you can keep the original pan in it, or a trunk pan could be replaced. It really is up to the new owner. Outside of that, you look at the rear frame rails, they're very solid. Quarter panels, very solid. You can see the rear underneath quarter panel connected, very solid. Floor pans, very solid on that side. If you look on this side, same thing. We're finding the quarter panel in really good condition. The inner panel's in really good condition. It's been undercoated years ago. That's in really good condition. Frame rail's really good. I can see inside the inside of the frame rail, very good condition. Now, some of the undercoating that was put on it years ago is flaking off, but we're double checking. Gas tank, really good condition. Okay, rear differential, once again, you can see the lower control arm bushings were done at some point. They're definitely fresh and new. Same thing with the shocks. You can see the springs have been replaced. It's got a newer spring in it. The exhaust is obviously new. Rear drums are not leaking, in very good condition. Rear seals, really good for the age of the car. Looks like the plug may be just leaking a little bit, but not bad. Okay. Upper trailing arm bushing has been replaced. Frame looks really solid. Floor looks really solid to this point. Like we get a little bit of seepage of something here. Can't tell if it's just from. Okay. Frame, like I said, someone has undercoated this, but it wasn't an effort to really hide anything. Everything looks really solid. Really good condition for its age. Shockingly. Rear end looks really good. This side, the bushing's been replaced, the spring's new. Everything's looking real good. It looks like right above the lower control arm on this side, at some point someone did some patchwork on the floor. You can see it should be readdressed and redone. Okay, moving forward. Left rear pan has been replaced. They did a decent job replacing it. Inner rocker panel looks to be in really good condition. Looks like this brace right here on the outer side could use a little work, but overall in good condition. Wow, this thing's freaking a time capsule. Okay, looks like the
passenger side rear floor pan. At some point, someone had done something. There's some, you can see rivets that are in here. It looks like they may have laid a little metal on the inside because this pan on this side is a little weak. She's not bad for her age. But you can see right here, she's a little soft. Outer rocker on this side. Great condition. Cross member, cross brace on this side, good condition. Frame rail, all metal. Really good condition. So the two spots that we found so far, well, three spots would be a little spot here by the rear control arm. This rear seat pan here can be addressed, but it's livable with. It's not something that I would really have to address if I was gonna daily drive it, but it's something that should be looked at either down the road or, and then on this side, the frame body brace itself, it's got a little bit of showing wear right here. Exhaust is new on the car. Rear tail shaft is leaking a little bit, which is expected. And when a car sits a long time, those seals shrink. We're solid. We lost storage in the iPhone, so we'll keep going here. So we're on the right side, floor pan underneath the door, and the outer rocker looks good. It looks like at some point someone had done some little work here, but it's solid. There's no mush, no rust. It's looking good. Okay. Moving on. Transmission. Like I said, looks really good condition. It's got a little bit of seepage here and there, but that's to be expected in a car this age, in a car that sits for long periods of time. Rear main seal seems to be good. I don't see any leaks from the rear main seal. Motor mounts have been replaced. They're in like new condition. You can see the lower A-arm bushings are like brand new. Everything's looking really good. Cross member. Really good springs in the front. Look to be some point replaced. Steering, pitman arm, everything looks to be all brand new, replaced. Steering box looks to be roughly good, in great condition. No oil leaks by the front seal. No fuel leaks. Fuel lines look really good, in good condition. Ball joints have been replaced on it. They're fairly new. It's got drum brakes in the front. Everything looks to be really, really good. Front core support. Car was really, really well maintained. For a 1951 Impala, I gotta say I'm impressed. Floor pans look really good. There we go. Got a little bit of something here. Looks like someone did a little weld work, patched it up. Not bad. Could be touched up. I'd say the undercarriage on this thing, I'm gonna give a solid 7, 7.5. But for its age, I think it's a 9, you know? This old girl is in really good condition. So, like I said, we found a few small spots on the floor that could be used some attention. Nothing that I would consider to be structurally, an issue. I think all this stuff is cosmetic. The frame on it seems to be really, really good. All the bushings are in really good condition. Come show the rockers. Out of the rockers. Looks really good. It looks like there's something dripping from the door, like maybe it's water coming out of the door on the bottom and it's dripping there. But fenders. Okay, left side rocker looks to be in really good condition. There's obviously signs that have been probably replaced at one time. See a little bit of, it's not really. Yeah, so the paint's bubbling a little bit. I don't want to do it. There we go. The rocker itself, a little soft there. It's a little soft, you can see a couple spots, but I don't think it's nothing that we can't, can't be patched up. You see the rocker itself, whatever body work they did years ago is holding up. Now remember that spot that I showed you on the driver's door corner? You can see that paint had been broken, and as a result, it's leaking, causing a little bit of issue right here, but nothing that can't be easily fixed and blended in. Wouldn't have to cause a repaint. Now, when I was outside, I was trying to show you this bubble, these bubbles right here. It's not a big deal, but it looks like if it's not addressed soon, that it could become an issue. And the rear quarter panel, it's in really great condition. So I hope that gives you guys a good indication of the quality of the car, and in doing so, please contact me with any questions. I'd be happy to point out any areas of interest that you have. So I hope that I did a good job for you, showing you the car. You can reach me at 561-929-6050. Talk to you soon.